Hello, my dear students. I hope you are great. Today we continue studying the future with will and want. Welcome to English class. Well, we're going to review the contracted forms. Vamos a revisar las formas abreviadas del will, que son mucho más comunes en el inglés hablado y escrito. I will es igual que I'll. You will es igual a you'll. He will, he'll. She will, she'll. It will, it'll. We will, we'll. They will, they'll. Recordemos que won't es la forma abreviada de will not, solo que se usa mucho más el won't. Vamos a ver ahora dos videos con algunos ejemplos de estas contracciones y también en qué ocasiones usamos will y won't.
Will and won't. What do we use them for? Well, firstly, we can use them to make promises. Secondly, we can use them to make offers. Thirdly, we use them to make spontaneous or quick decisions. Sometimes we even use them to make spontaneous threats. And finally, we also use them to make predictions about the future. Let's have a look at the positive and negative forms and their contractions. The positive is will. Examples of positive contractions are I'll, you'll, and will. The negative is will not. The negative contraction is won't. Now, when we talk, we usually use contractions. To summarize, there are four functions of will and won't. 1. To make promises. 2. To make offers. 3. To make spontaneous or quick decisions. And 4. To make predictions about the future.
You're too simple. Will. Use predictions, promises, spontaneous plans. Practice. Next week, we'll go out for dinner. Won't stay in. He'll serve drinks. He won't fall down. You'll order pizza. You won't order a fish. I'll sit on a chair. I won't stand on the table. She'll ask for water. She won't ask for Coke. They'll cook the food. They won't burn it. It'll be delicious. It won't be horrible.
That's it. Por hoy no tenemos taller, pero recuerden que mañana tenemos quiz. Después del quiz vamos a hacer una actividad en clase, así que muy pendientes. See you tomorrow, students. Bye bye.